Monday, January 12th, 2015. Searchers have found the black boxes from that crashed Air Asia flight. I'm Taylor Becker.
And I'm Caleb Harper. The NFL is down to their final four. We'll tell you who Vegas thinks is going to the Super Bowl. Your CSN news starts now.
The airliner that crashed 2 weeks ago in Indonesia likely experienced an explosion before hitting the water due to the significant change in air pressure. A senior government official said on Monday. He also said that the left side of the plane seemed to be disintegrated, pointing to a change in pressure that could have caused an explosion. Other experts disagree, and now searchers have found both black boxes and recovered one. We're soon to have a better idea what really happened.
The AFC and NFC championship games are set. The Green Bay Packers will face the Seattle Seahawks for the NFC Championship, and the Indianapolis Colts will face the New England Patriots. Although you may have a favorite team, broadcasters are hoping to see the Seahawks play the Patriots in the Super Bowl. Why? A West Coast-East Coast game means more viewers. What does Vegas say? It looks like they're expecting the Seahawks to repeat as Super Bowl champs.
An outside researcher and microbial expert made headlines recently with claims that a photo by Mars Curiosity rover had strong signs of former microbial life. But the Curiosity team said they doubt that that is the case. NASA says they don't think there was anything in the photo that couldn't be explained by the natural process of water transporting sand. And the rock was probably just a fluval sandstone. Adding to that, there were members of the team who look out for such biological signs, but they didn't see any reason to further explore that site. We'll be right back.
Are you interested in putting your skills to the test or looking for something to put on your resume? SkillsUSA might be for you. If you're a part of broadcasting, construction, photography, welding, or one of the many other programs at any of the schools, consider joining us. SkillsUSA has a vast reach in areas to compete in, so odds are there's something for you. If you're interested, see Mr. Allen at Columbia, Mr. Babcock at Nampa, or Mr. Miller at Skyview. So come on down and see what it's all about. You'll be glad that you did.
Today's weather is brought to you by Dr. Kim Keller. Your smile is your first impression. Make it a good one and visit Dr. Keller today.
Today's high is 39, the low of 24 with snow and rain. Tomorrow's high is 34, the low of 22, but it's mostly sunny.
If you are interested in traveling to England, spring break of 2016, with Mr. Buckridge and Miss Lindsay, there will be an informational student-parent meeting this Thursday, January 15th at 6 p.m. in room 656. Please let Mr. Buckridge know or Miss Lindsay know if you cannot make the meeting.
The yearbook purchase deadline is Friday. And it's quickly approaching. Don't miss out on this year's incredible yearbook. A $35 deposit will hold a copy for you, and you can pay the remainder when they arrive in May.
Friday and Saturday, the NHS Booster will be sponsoring a readout for the American Heart Association during the girls' and boys' basketball games. There will be $10 t-shirts for sale beginning this Monday in the Pro Shop.
There will be an important FCCLA meeting today after school in Miss Radford's room at 108. And don't forget, this Thursday is our Winter Spirit Assembly, and all three high schools will be on Assembly Bell schedule that day.
Today's SAT word of the day is immerse, a verb that means to drop, usually into liquid, to plunge, to absorb one's attention completely.
You could use it this way. While on student exchange, Stephanie tried to immerse herself in the country's culture, trying out new foods and speaking only in Italian.
That's the news. We'll see you again tomorrow right here on the Bulldog Edition.